Rajiv ji, I think as we've discussed, thank you to Bibhavani for inviting the us to be here and have these interactions, because what we believe that the science for society cannot progress without the discussions with the society and knowing more and more and bridging the gap. I will request after my presentations if there is some questions to be there, and then my colleague can continue, because there is a meeting in PSA office, already this is same time on SDG, and there was a call to join there. So after this I can take some questions, and then I if you allow I can just go and attend that other meeting. So I will just have it, I will use these PPT for these interactions. Can you see it? Yeah, is it visible?
It is actually, and now we can see.
Yes,
we can see, sir.
So basically, the title itself says that the SEED division, the Science for Equity Empowerment, the Development Divisions of the DSE, that is our focus, the social empowerment and the sustainable development goals, how we see it. I thought that initially, rather going before the project or the program itself, what is the philosophy with which we work? And I believe Bibhavani also work into that same philosophy. We work with the empowerment, as we understand that the empowerment in the different forms, the woman or youth empowerment, which is the beneficiary orientations. There is a political economic empowerment, which is a social issue. Digital knowledge empowerment, which is a more often technological empowerment. And for us, it is the vulnerable sections is the main focus. And the societal empowerment, when we look it from the science and technology, our focus is to reduce the inequalities, creations of the equitable inclusive growth, and the creations of the sustainable and the resilient communities. So these are the goals, the outcomes with which we work from the state. While doing this empowerment, at the center of this is the livelihood system of the community. The livelihood system, as we know, consists of the five capitals: the human capital, the natural capital, financial capital, physical capital, the social capital. Different types of the uncertainty creates that the vulnerability on these different aspects of the capitals. And what we want, support from the science and technology and the innovation perspective, how to reduce those uncertainties and create resilience at the livelihood level. So that the livelihood outcomes, if we can have a sustainable livelihood strategy, and the livelihood outcome, which again strengthen the livelihood system. So in that context, we look into the natural social sciences, we look into the artisans, local indigenous knowledge, as an integration or the continuum of this science or the knowledge to the societal empowerment of the community. While doing so, we also keep on the larger developmental framework, which currently all of you know is a sustainable development goal, which work on these three axes. Of environment for sustainable use of the resources, economy, obviously for the economic and the business growth of the community, and the society or the good quality of the life of the community. So what to achieve this sustainability, how we can empower by using the science and technological tools, evidence-based reasoning, understandings of the cause and effect. So it is not only the technology, also the knowledge and the science for taking for the sustainable and the empowerment of the community are the process in which we look into. And learning adaptive management, so that the sustainable development, what I always tell about that the UN has given this SDG, but I always consider it as in 30,000 or 32,000 feet view as you go in a flight. But the real sustainability examples are we need to take into where the community lives, that is a 10 feet down, the view. As you know, that when we bring the science and technology, the development of that, any science and technological development have to have an evidence-based. The evidence-based with the data, the conversions with the data, and the the informations, then the intelligence and the knowledge. And this intelligence and the knowledge can come from the both the way. Like we always want to focus that this intelligence and knowledge cannot be one directional. It cannot be the only the scientist and technology saying their community that this is it and you take it for your development. Rather, the communities for their, if you see for their livelihood, have acquired a lot of the intelligence and knowledge. And we want to harness it and improve it with the science and technology. So in that context, our main the approach is the for a knowledge society and a sustainable development, the knowledge, science and technology and the innovations, this makes the strengthens the bottom of the pyramid so that the absorption capacity of the science and technology at the bottom of the pyramid improves. We can create a resilient society and ultimately a sustainable goal. So in this direction, the constraints are the knowledge acquisitions, knowledge applications, and the knowledge creations. And there is a big systemic, the gap in that, what we are going to discuss. And that those are the gaps at which basically what we want to work towards. If we look from the governmental perspective or the societal empowerment, there are different welfare ministries. There is the Ministry of Tribal Affairs, this is the Ministry of the Social Justice, there are Swabalamban schemes, there are the schemes for the social justice, there are schemes for the Divangians, Ministry of Minority Affairs have the schemes, and this is the, you see that the main focus of these societal welfare ministries are mostly in terms of the equality, so that the direct welfare can bring that the equality and the inclusions by providing the direct benefit. But the role of the science and technology is at the back, at a lower value chain of it to strengthen this welfare system through the through constant evolutions of the new science science and technology centric knowledge. If you see here, while we do this, we also look into the science and technology policy, which has evolved more towards a human centric way. If you look into this 1958 scientific policy resolution, it was more on the scientific temper and the capacity building. Then in 83, it was more of a technological competence and self-reliance. And a big focus was on mostly on the infrastructure building. In the 2003 science and technology policy, it increased in the investment in the R&D for more and more utilization of the science and technology for the societal development. The 2013 science and technology innovation policy, it's more of an SNT-led innovation for the socioeconomic development. And the current 2020-21 STIP, what we are working on, they are more focused on the mainstreaming the equity, inclusion in the science, technology, and innovations for the societal empowerment. So if I think many of you who are knowing a Department of Science and Technology or who doesn't know the science Department of Science and Technology, this is the totally DST's landscape. Basically, the DST works for the human capacity building, research development, technology mission, socioeconomic development, aided institutions at the SY and the the NATMO. And so the SNT communities are our main the stakeholders. So what we try to do, new areas and applications of the R&D support, strengthening the science, technology, innovation infrastructure, technology development, deployment, innovation, and the entrepreneurship development, and the science and technology policy development, commercialization. We try to enhance one in the number of the active quality scientists, quality relevance of the research report, the discovery solutions, equitable inclusive growth in the society, and strengthening the science diplomacy in the context of an international collaboration. So as one example that if you see that currently of the DST's, this from 1971, this year we are celebrating the 50 years of our existence. India is now third in terms of the international publications. Also, in terms of the Global Innovation Index, in the last 5 years, India has risen from the 82 positions to now, 81 positions to now, it is 48. So this is the, if you now look it into the other aspects of the science and technology ecosystem, that's mainly the research and the infrastructure. This is the part of the human face of the science and technology, which basically focuses towards the societal, the different sections of the society. The Kiran divisions, which work mostly for the women for bringing the gender parity, the Inspired divisions, which work for the motivating students to pursue career in the science, especially the science SC and the ST community, with a component of the SCN community, not men. The SITS, which I look after, is for creating equity and empowerment to the most vulnerable sections of the SST intervention. Also, the SCRB has the scheme which focuses towards the SC and ST researchers and their capacity. So the SID division, if you see that now what we work towards is the development and deployment of the science-led solutions and location-specific appropriate technology for creation of sustainable livelihood, mostly, as I've told, that the vulnerable sections of the society. Goal is empowering for the inclusive development in sustainable manner. This is our approach. We support inclusive growth for improving livelihood and food security through the application of science, technology, and the innovations. We promote economic diversification, product transformations for the rural employment in order to improve the strength or the efficiency of the livelihood system, promote access to the services, skill development, training, capacity building for the science and technology-led developmental or strengthening the welfare system on the ground, and ensure the sustainability, harnessing the benefits of the natural resources. Because as more and more we go into a resource-constrained livelihood system, the more and more dependency of the natural resources is there. It's most important, even in the context of a livelihood system development, of keeping a balance between the availability of the natural resources. So that ultimately we want to include the inclusiveness, the equity, for the disadvantaged sections of the society through science and technology. So this is our framework for the harnessing the science and technology. We identify the needs and priority of the vulnerable sections. We support the natural science, social science, technology development, innovations to work together as a continuum. We support linking knowledge to action and interventions for the socioeconomic development for creating inclusions at the equity. Now coming to our different programs, I would like to start with the one of the main important program for the women. Like, there is a program under Kiran, like what is basically the science and technology, the empowerment participations of women in science and technology, like where we support the women with a career break to come back in the science and technology. But this is the program, in the unique program, where we look into the science and technology applications for these women. The women during the entire life cycle have certain unique problems, how to address that to the science and technology, and so that the empowerment of the women to take place with the science and technology applications, not just by participation in the enterprise of the science and technology. Ultimately, to promote gender equality, equity, the development adaptations of the technology, so the absorption capacity building, transfer applications of the proven technology. So this is on the right hand side. You see like some of the output and the outcome of our this program. This is some of the examples. We work with the women at the grassroots level, like for ornamental fish breeding, for introductions as a livelihood diversions and bringing them to the higher value chain of the activity, value additions of the NTFPs, creations of the field germplasm bank for combating fodder shortage. So these are the science and technology. Like if you see that each of these interventions at the core of it is the science and the technological intervention. The water conservation technologies, biofertilizers, like you can see the name of the organizations. This is an example in the, in one of the non-governmental organizations. They train the young, the girls of class 10 and class 12 in this tissue culture, so that the locally relevant, the plants can be introduced there, but after these, the genetic engineering there. So this is an example of where the high level of the technology can be brought to the community to bring them into the higher value, the value chain of their activities. Like these are post-harvest technologies, as you see the number of the women, this is an example of out of a program. Similarly, that solar dryer, biomass based tray dryer, that this was All India basis, All India coordinated projects, an outcome of that. Technology modulations for the different type of dryers were used in different places. This is an example for a coastal region. Generally, in the coastal region, the women they are involved into a very lower value chain of the entire fishing activity, and mostly their work can be menial. So, how in order to improve that, the new technologies have been improved, and also the new seaweed as a new application of the life has been introduced there, so that there is not only an increase in the income but also increase in their own protein intake for improving their health. This is one program we have, this seems to be the core of the seed program, which is called technology application for the rural areas of the Tara. This is a long-term core support for the science-based voluntary organizations in the field institutions, so that they work as in science and technology incubators in the active field laboratories in order to provide the technological solution at the grassroots. In other words, they basically work as a link between the communities, understanding the community's pulse and the science and technology requirement there, and linking with the S&T-based knowledge organizations to transfer those technologies and to build up capacity in the community. But till now, it was done mostly by the NGOs. Now we are evolving this program, which I will share with you. This is some of the examples of that. As you see, that some machineries and the tools for the post-harvest technologies. And this is a very good the technology, which is solar-based technology, has been brought it into the very rural area where there is no electricity, so that the adult educations can be given introduced by using this. The solar-based projectors. When the people come back from the field, then they can be introduced to the educations, and also the students, especially during these COVID situations, they have been brought into the mainstream educations by using this the solar-based projector. In the case of the housing, very locally appropriate technology for the housing, especially in the hilly areas, and the other the disaster prone areas have been developed. Food processing, many of the value additions has been done through the different projects. The energy lighting in the fuel, the left hand side, I think you must have seen here. This is basically the solar dome. The solar dome in the here, it has been used in a where there is no electricity connection, so that can be introduced there, especially the tribal villages. They have been just one minute. Hello. Hi. I'm thoda meeting mein hu, baad mein baat karta hu. So. These are the and these are all basically the the Make in India, and this shows our the future, the building blocks of the Atmanirbharata, which our honorable Prime Minister is harping at every point. We also work on the ICT based technologies, different the rural the technologies for improving the livelihood system efficiency. Some of the significant achievements, which has been upscaled. This is in Himachal Pradesh. This solar dryer has been used disseminated to a larger community for boiling of the water and also drying their crops. Microwavable terracotta pot has been developed in IRTC Palakkad, Kerala. This is Vigyan Ashram in Pune. They have developed in solar egg incubators. So these are the examples that how the welfare system is getting strengthened by bringing the higher end by developing the capacity of the community in the higher end activity. We have a unique program for the Divyangjan and the elderly. It's called the TIDE, the Technology Intervention for the Divyangjan and Elderly. The focus here is on improving or supporting the assistive technology in the country. In the country, the assistive technology in 98% are imported. So here, basically, we support different knowledge institutions to develop this prototype and also work with the Ministry of Social Development for commercializations of this at a low cost and an adaptable way. We have a program for the knowledge, the socially relevant knowledge development needs the people who are oriented in the research toward the socially oriented problems. For that, we have this program for the scheme for young scientists and technologists. So here we try generally the people coming from the natural sciences, how they can pick a problem and orient their research towards that. Then we have a program for the scheduled caste, under scheduled caste subplan and the tribal subplan. As you know, like these are the the mandatory programs for the government of India. And here, basically what we do in the to bridge the gap in socioeconomic conditions of this disadvantaged society to the science and technology. The objective is to promote research and development adoption technology for improving the quality of life. We encourage scientists and technologists to apply their knowledge for this community's problem, replicate the successful technology models, as Rajivji was talking about, that to develop that type of models that for technical capacity building and skill development. So we support those type of a project where the project investigator belong to the SCST community, or 30 to 40% of the beneficiary belong to the SCST community. So then the tribal tribal supplant TSP, that we have this program for the tribal community. And as an impact of that, as you see here, like one, we have done analysis of around 2 decades of our this project support. We see that people are now, we could make people aware about the sustainable livelihood activities, safe drinking water, advanced agriculture technology, improvement in the animal health and the decline in the animal mortality, the sanitation, technology absorption rate has increased, school dropout rate has decreased, increase in income, and the overall improved in the quality of the life. So this is we had a coordinated program under scheduled caste subplan, and this is the output of that, which shows that the higher level of the science and technology based activities have been introduced for this community development, as you see here, like all these activities have been introduced by the science and technological the interventions have been made for improving their efficiency of that. Similarly, for a tribal community, we have this coordinated in the project for the people protected areas. This is at the bordering of the forest, where the people have got displaced because of the Forest Act, and how to diversify the livelihood system so that their the livelihood for their economic empowerment, and as well as their overall livelihood system, the shock can be absorbed. So what we look at into that, the entire the sustainable development goal and the different aspects of that, where the science and technology can really create an example at the ground level, we focus on that. As you see here, the different SDG, we work towards the different the sustainable development goals. Now as you see, like when Rajivji requested me, there is a call for proposal for a science, technology, and innovation hub for the SCST community. So why this was a requirement? Because we analyzed our individual, given the projects, what we supported over time of about 2 decades, and found that they cannot really create a sustainable impact unless and until we think it is in a system context. Therefore, we started this program on the science, technology, innovation based development and delivery programs for improving the livelihood system with a bottom-up approach to identify the strongest and weakest link in the predominant livelihood system. And whether the weakest links to improve that with the science and technology intervention, and the strongest link by utilizing it through science and technology for the social entrepreneurship. Generally, what happens is that the people look into one problem and then try to bring a science, you know, that science and technological interventions, that as long as the project is over, you know, the sustenance become a challenge. So the STI hubs, the objective is to address the weakest linkage in the predominant livelihood system, creations of the social entrepreneurship, as I've told, for the strongest aspects, and to improve the indigenous knowledge system through the input of the science and technology hub. So we want to support through cross-bridge collaborations. And this, when I say cross-bridge collaborations, means to science and technology knowledge organizations who are locally, who are located in a more near to this community, and they work with the network of the NGOs, so that the knowledge organizations always cannot directly convert their knowledge to the community. So they always work with a network of the NGOs, and at the back end, they are linked with the higher institute of the education and the knowledge, like the IITs or the agriculture universities and the NITs in that area. So these are the some of the indicative aspects while we consider while proposing the S&T interventions of the weakest and the strongest link, availability of the local resources, remove drudgery, able to enhance efficacy, livelihood system, empowerment, bringing community to the higher market value chain, and the adaptable and the affordable interventions. So these are some of the critical socioeconomic aspects of the SCST community in which we focus. As you can see here, starting from the basic requirement of the water and sanitation to the education, health, nutrition, social security, and the financial inclusion, digitization, and also the focus of the indigenous knowledge system. So after this, I just want to share with you, till now, from the last year itself, after COVID, and also during this, the coming financial commissions, we are in a evolution to the developmental phase of the seat. I just want to share with you that this was the recommendations were that there needs to be revised the scheme focusing on social innovation, entrepreneurship, capturing the actual requirement, livelihood diversification, skill development, adoptions of the modern technology. And as you see here, already we are doing in that area. So what we are trying to evolve, it's mostly till now the focus was in the rural area, but it is now the requirement also for the urban and the peri-urban area. In tune to the increased expectations and the aspirations of the people, we need to consider that any developmental interventions along with the natural resource available in that area, so that there is a budget between the demand and the supply, and the technology-led entrepreneurship and social innovations, again, in order to improve the strongest, the link in the livelihoods in that area. So in by doing this, what we, like as Rajivji was talking about. Hello. Hello. Yeah. Hello. There is a lot of background. So while looking into the context of the Atmanirbhar Bharat, when we analyzed at the system level, we found that there is significant system. Please, can you just put your microphone off, please? What we find it out that the S&T absorption capacity of the community is our ultimate goal of the science STI system. The technological knowledge improvement of the voluntary organization CBOs is the next important thing, because there is a constant improvement in the knowledge. And the other important thing is the orientations of our S&T knowledge organization to address the local problem through the science technology. Because in general, our knowledge organizations are at ease with the global knowledge, the ecosystem. But the need of Atmanirbhar Bharat is to organize and reorient them towards our problem solving. That can be a basic research as well as an applications of the translation. So the the current pandemic has given more important of this Atmanirbharata and the self-sufficiency, which our honorable prime minister is emphasizing on. And therefore, we are mostly work towards the knowledge capacity in the livelihood system to make his dream of vocal for local unity in the reality. So this is the, you know, the setu, what we want to make is the science society setu. The society, it's basically the our focus, the knowledge organizations and the NGOs and the startups, basically they work as in setu between the layman, government and ministry support. So we want to, you know, the triple helix of the sustainability, we want to strengthen creations of the social enterprise, as I've already discussed about. We translate the knowledge into application to maximize the impact, and also the appropriate interventions to fuel innovation. Innovation, now one thing what we are understanding till now from the you know the green revolutions, the focus was on from the lab to land, and probably the time has come now to look from the land to lab. The innovations of the real practitioners or the farmers or the artisans, we must understand and respect that, and the science and technology and the scientists and technologists should work with that to improve that, so that they can own that improvement rather than bringing innovations as a system from outside from the livelihood. That is the reason we are focusing more and more on learning from the local community. So the mapping, the traditional knowledge and the indigenous skills, disseminations of the knowledge, impact of the communication technology, local development, bottom-up and the top-down approach, where should they meet, and the heritage, the local cultural traditions, because ultimately India, more than 70% live in the, you know, the rural area, and that the culture, traditions, the science, the wisdom of that needs to be captured. So this is the way that we want to, you know, we are evolving. So for the technology delivery package, we have these programs called Women Technology Park. Again, for the cross-bridge collaborations between the NGOs and the knowledge institutions and the social enterprise, as well as the societal the organizations. And the STI have for the SCST. The TARA is for the other parts of the, the majority of the community. And for the technology development and the knowledge development, we have this program, SYST, TIDE, SNT for Women, and also for the social enterprise development. And ultimately, this is a new concept what we have bought. Ultimately, what we are looking into the community resilience. Because the resilience, generally, we think about against the natural disasters or the climate change. But the community faces resilience, the uncertainty from different aspects. So how to improve that by SNT intervention? That's the reason that we are thinking, we have already conceptualized and going to establish the 75 Distakop and pilot community resilience center across the country during these 75 years of our the celebrations of independence. So this is the community COVID resilience resource center. Like what we are doing, that whatever our existing this technology, technology transfer mechanisms, and based on that based on that experience we are making it. But we are integrating that with the state SNT councils, with the knowledge organizations, the other CBOs and the community based organizations, so that we can reduce the uncertainties in the communities and improve their resilience. So this is overall that what I need to say. I will now leave it on to my colleague Dr. Gopi Krishna to discuss more about that how the guidelines and how to develop a project for this STI hub, what I have discussed in detail. But at this point, if you have any questions, because there is already all of me from the PSA office before I joined. I really thank Rajiv Ji for giving me this, opportunity. And Gopi, I am unsharing you. Can you share now, Gopi?
Yeah, you can please unshare, sir. I will share my presentation.
Yeah, or beforehand, anyone has any questions, like me to refer to any of these. Rajiv ji, please.
Yeah. Dr. Datta, it was a very exhaustive presentation from your side, and we are happy that You have personally came to this webinar and presented all the developments under SEED program. And I think there are a lot of areas where Vibhavani can intervene for because we have a pan-India presence, and today's meeting also, almost 18 states are participating in this webinar, selected organizations, and more than 70 are attending. So there can be areas beyond this particular project proposal, like this STI hub, where we can associate in a very productive manner. Our focus is mainly on capacity building, enterprise development, and technology intervention. So I think SEED's objective and Vibhavani's objective was very much synchronized, and we can also see how we can promote these type of activities to the voluntary organizations. So I am thanking you for making this presentation, so that we have some idea what is the role of SEED in these technology interventions and livelihood.
Like that's the reason I spoke a little bit about that, the, you know, philosophy behind it, what we do, like rather than only the program and the project.
Yeah, it was very comprehensive, but only thing is we need more deliberations on many of the aspects, because a huge volume of information you have given us in the last one half an hour. So there are a lot of areas where we need to deliberate more and work out with some action plan, because most of our organizations are in different levels, because in Vibhavani there are around 1,800 organizations connected at the grassroots level, and not all the organizations are on the same levels. Some are having a lot of infrastructure and manpower is there. Some are upcoming organizations are also there. So, but they have very good reach towards the target communities like SCSTs and other people. So there can be different type of activities. That is only a suggestions from my side. And I request any of our members who wants to ask some questions, because Dr. Datta has another meeting. So if any quick questions are there, we will entertain. Otherwise, I request Datta to share this presentation so that I can forward. If you are willing to share, I can forward the presentation to all our members. So anyone wants to raise some questions quickly?
Hello.
Yes.
Yeah.
Please go ahead.
Yeah, हाँ, मैं मंजू शर्मा भोपाल से बात कर रही हूँ. अभय अभय नारी हमारा एक महिला फोकस्ड एनजीओ है, जिसमें हम लोग विमेन एसएचजीज के साथ काम कर रहे हैं हेल्थ एजुकेशन एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप विषय पे. आपने जो तारा स्कीम के बारे में बताया, हम लोग इसके लिए कैसे अप्लाई कर सकते हैं, क्योंकि हमारा भी ऑब्जेक्टिव यही है. छोटा जो टेक्नोलॉजी है, खासकर मैनुअल जो चीजें हैं, वो महिलाओं तक कैसे लेके जाएं, ताकि वो पूरा अपना जो प्रोसेस है फूड का या जो भी उनके प्रोडक्ट्स हैं, उनको वो घर पे आसानी से कर सकें. तो ये हम लोग कैसे आपके साथ जोड़ सकते हैं, प्रपोजल्स कैसे हम लोग शेयर करेंगे?
मेरा सलाह यही रहेगा कि लेके तारा की जगह आप जो हमारे वुमेन टेक्नोलॉजी के इंसेंटिव फॉर वुमेन के जो प्रोग्राम है, स्पेशली आप एक WTP और वुमेन टेक्नोलॉजी पार्क सोच सकते हैं. तो मेरा सलाह ये रहेगा कि पहले तो आप देख लीजिए कि वहाँ जो आजीविका के जो सिस्टम है, आप जहाँ काम करते हैं उसमें जो आजीविका सिस्टम के जो 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 वीकेस्ट लिंक और स्ट्रॉन्गेस्ट लिंक क्या है, और ये आपको पता होगा. मैं जस्ट इसको सिस्टम पर्सपेक्टिव में डाल रहा हूँ इसीलिए कि उसके बाद आप वहाँ का जो जब ये आपको पता चल जाएगा, आप उस वहाँ उधर के जो रिसेंटली नॉलेज इंस्टीट्यूशन जिनके साथ आप काम करना चाहते उनके साथ करके ये टेक्नोलॉजी आप वहाँ ले आ सकते हैं, और हमारे एक वुमेन टेक्नोलॉजी पार्क आप तैयार कर सकते हैं. और उसमें हम जो अभी जो वोमेन को ट्रेनिंग दे रहे हैं, हम उनको ये भी करते हैं कि जो नेशनल स्किल काउंसिल है उनकी जो स्टैंडर्डाइजेशन के तहत उनको स्टैंडर्डाइज किया जाए, क्योंकि जब आप लोग आप जब ट्रेनिंग देके तो निकल आएंगे तो एक NCS ट्रेंड वोमेन पावर विल बी अवेलेबल देयर जो फील्ड में, जो कि आप जब वहां से विथड्रॉ करेंगे उसके बाद भी उन लोगों का एम्प्लॉयबिलिटी बढ़ेगा.
बिल्कुल सस्टेनेबल रहे
प्रोजेक्ट. सस्टेनेबल
रहेगा.
डॉक्टर दत्ता, विभावानी इज ट्राइंग टू हैव सम कोलैबोरेशंस एट द ग्रासरूट लेवल. that is working along with the academic and research institutions and also the grassroots organizations. Mm-hmm. So if we come bring together the local institutions like academic institutions and the grassroots organizations together and apply for some projects, that would be a synergy will be developed because each have their own strengths.
Exactly what you have told, like, you know, our focus is also like rather than only academic institutions, R&D institutions given or only NGO given, in a collaborative mode, in the cross-bridge collaborations to support. And that's the future, like, you know, how we can do it. And yes, rather you can involve also the SHGs and the FPOs there so that ultimately the capacity gets built into them, because that's our goal.
Yes,
actually, that is one of the prerequisites for this STI hubs also.
Very good, very good. Yeah. So any other questions, quick questions? I don't see any question in the chat box, but I am sure that a lot of people have so many questions in their mind. But I think we will consolidate these questions and come back to you another day, because there is a details of the whatever you have presented need to be deliberated, then only we can arrive at the right questions and right solutions.
I am open and ready to for any, like, in a longer deliberation. This was just an introduction, because you told, like, recently, you know, like, we had a capacity building workshops for the real community based organization, as you were saying, because we also understand that the there are the entire value chain, the people have different level of the capacity and different focus.
Yes.
So each of them have their own role to play, and accordingly the capacity needs to be played. And you cannot measure them with the same scale.
Correct. Yeah.
So we are aware of that, and accordingly we work with it. Recently, like 2 weeks before, we had an online, the 2 days long program for the capacity building of the CBOs or the community-based organizations by our core support group NGOs, and where the other experts also joined. So more and more we were going, as you said, that the more focused on the cross-bridge collaboration.
Yeah, so Vibhavani will also initiate some of the capacity building programs along with SEED, so that we can include all the members of Vibhavani who are not actually aware about a lot of the activities going on under the SEED department, SEED division. So we will initiate some capacity development programs, capacity building programs. And also we are also in the process of shortlisting some technologies under CSIR, VNIT, and I am also part of National Innovation Foundation, where some cost-effective technologies are already in place, which can generate some livelihood to the clusters of SEST, women, etc. So we are actually going to introduce some technologies and link with some of the government schemes also, which are handholding to cluster formation under MSME and other.
Just you know, out of our experience, one just suggestions, Rajiv ji, that, you know, before till now, what has happened, like, we have done the cluster formation based on the technology, like, you know, availability of the technology from the different sources. Rather than, you know, like, out of, like, I always say that our experience of the 74th year, that, you know, like, the technology-driven thing, it's very difficult to sustain. Rather than on the other side, if we start looking into the livelihood system analysis and look it into that, what is the specific requirement of the technology and bring it there. Rather, till now, what we do, basically, we go to the CSIR labs and say, like, these are the prototypes available. Then we feel like, you know, do the field-level demonstrations and try to develop. And it's very difficult for the community to absorb that way. So we are working with basically with IRMA, you know, Indian Rural Management, like Anand, to develop that livelihood system analysis in a very simple way, which is CBOs and the NGOs can do and can find it out what is the weakest link. And therefore, maybe the same technology we bring, but when we withdraw, we can say ki ye ajibika ka system mein itna part humko apko maine strengthen kiya hai, baki jo hai is technology se karna hai. So that the technology become a you know, like, technology doesn't become the main driver, rather the society become the main driver.
Yeah,
that is the requirement.
Yeah, right. So more and more need-based technologies can be
introduced. Rather, I will say not need-based, because, you know, that is the word we have taken for the information system part of it. We will say rather it is our community system based. Because the knowledge introductions and the S&T introduction cannot take place at an individual level. It has to be done at a system level. And unless and until we understand that, actually, what we are, I am proposing, you see in our country, from the natural resource, whatever the classification is there from a supply side, and we have, you know, agroecological zones, we have land use system planning, but we do not, now what we need isn't, our, you know, India has a unique livelihood system. That livelihood system mapping nobody has done. Like, you know, unless and until we do, you do not know that what is the demand. So that is the requirement of the time now.
See, for your information, Vibhavani is, has declared that for next 1 year, our focus will be on Swavalambi Bharat, Samruddha Bharat, as far as the 75th year of Indian independence is concerned. So we are more focused on the self-reliance and rural prosperity. So we can have more programs aligned with the STI interventions for livelihood. So this can be a starting point. So again,
sir, I would want to add in something. I was hearing sir's deliberation on this thing, on the reverse mapping of the technologies. So in that context, I would like to add in that there are many farmers who are working with us, and as in the natural resource management field also, we are facing a big problem in processing of the medicinal herbs, or you can say farm producers. So there may be technologies which are developed for peeling, for good peeling. Say, for example, if we want to peel in shatavar. Shatavar is one of the like medicinal herbs which is being widely used in Ayurveda now, and it is being cultivated. It is not being sourced out from the collection source now. And what the problem we are facing is we do not have good peelers, and it is a very labor-intensive work. And we need a peeler, a proper peeler to be developed. So if there is any technology which is there with the DST, which can be brought down to the farmers, this kind of technology we need. There are small interventions. We do not need big technologies. We need very small, practically implementable technologies which we want to bring into the community, because there is such kind of need. And we don't like, there is for waste management also, there is a technology which requires, I mean, which incinerates the waste, the agri waste and everything, and it converts it into either gas or into like electricity. So that kind of technology we need to bring it down to the community level, so that even the community can understand that it benefits. It benefits from the good effects of that technology, and it is simple to use, because we cannot implement very big machinery-based technologies. We need very small machinery-based technologies and easy to implement technologies at the ground level. So that is what I would want to, I mean, like if there are these kind of technologies, they need to be brought down to the NGOs so that they can implement it down the line. So I would want to have a comment from sir regarding this kind of technology which can be transferred.
Yes, madam. Like, no, definitely. Like, you know, this we have this technology, this type of available. What is the problem again at a system level is this type of technologies are there in many of the places. You know, it is available in the NIF. You know, the network. It is available in the some of the CSIR. What is needed today is like someone like as you are facing a problem at a field level. You that type of an you know. The national available database needs to be developed. So we need to work with you, and we are working with the PSA office to develop that type of a you know repository of that.
Yes. Vibhavani is also taking some initiatives for showcasing all these type of technologies which are having some demand from the grassroots level. NIF National Innovation Foundation has already digitalized around 1.5 lakh technologies, and it is available in the innovation portal. And